Welcome to our time of scripture reading and devotional reflection for Tuesday, May the 10th, 2022. My name is Pastor Brian J. Monroe, and this is coming to you from my office in Kitimat First Baptist Church, situated in beautiful Kitimat, British Columbia, and it's truly a beautiful day as I record this. I have three passages of scripture to read for you so that you can hear the Word of God and let the Word of God just wash over you and do what it will do. I also have a devotional to read to you from Oswald Chambers' classic daily devotional, My Utmost for His Highest. So let me please begin by reading Psalm 100, a psalm for giving thanks. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing. Know that the Lord, he is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him. Bless his name. For the Lord is good. His steadfast love endures forever, and his faithfulness to all generations. Ezekiel chapter 45, verses 1 to 9. When you allot the land as an inheritance, you shall set apart for the Lord a portion of the land as a holy district, 25,000 cubits long and 20,000 cubits broad. It shall be holy throughout its whole extent. Of this, a square plot of 500 by 500 cubits shall be for the sanctuary, with 50 cubits for an open space around it. And from this measured district you shall measure off a section 25,000 cubits long and 10,000 broad, in which shall be the sanctuary, the most holy place. It shall be the holy portion of the land. It shall be for the priests who minister in the sanctuary and approach the Lord to minister to him. And it shall be a place for their houses and a holy place for the sanctuary. Another section, 25,000 cubits long and 10,000 cubits broad, shall be for the Levites who minister at the temple as their possession for cities to live in. Alongside the portion set apart as the holy district, you shall assign for the property of the city an area 5,000 cubits broad and 25,000 cubits long. It shall belong to the whole house of Israel. And to the prince shall belong the land on both sides of the holy district and the property of the city, alongside the holy district and the property of the city on the west and on the east, corresponding in length to one of the tribal portions, and extending from the western to the eastern boundary of the land. It is to be his property in Israel. And my princes shall no more oppress my people, but they shall let the house of Israel have the land according to their tribes. Thus says the Lord God, enough, O princes of Israel. Put away violence and oppression, and execute justice and righteousness. Cease your evictions of my people, declares the Lord God. Acts chapter 9, verses 32 to 35. Now as Peter went here and there among them all, he came down also to the saints who lived in Lydda. There he found a man named Aeneas, bedridden for 8 years, who was paralyzed. And Peter said to him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ heals you. Rise and make your bed. And immediately he rose. And all the residents of Lydda and Sharon saw him, and they turned to the Lord. This is your holy word, Almighty Father God, and we praise you for the gracious provision of it to us. Grant us through the power of your Holy Spirit the ability to take it in, to understand it, to have it work your what is your good pleasure in our lives to your great purpose. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And from Oswald Chambers' My Utmost for His Highest, we read, Take the initiative. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness knowledge. That is, furnish your faith with resolution. 2 Peter 1, chapter 1, verse 5. Add means there is something we have to do. We are in danger of forgetting that we cannot do what God does, and that God will not do what we can do. We cannot save ourselves nor sanctify ourselves. God does that. But God will not give us good habits. He will not give us character. He will not make us walk aright. We have to do all that ourselves. We have to work out the salvation God has worked in. Add means to get into the habit of doing things, and in the initial stages it is difficult. To take the initiative is to make a beginning, to instruct yourself in the way you have to go. Beware of the tendency of asking the way when you know it perfectly well. Take the initiative. Stop hesitating and take the first step. I want to parenthetically say here, stop asking what would Jesus do. Just do what you know Jesus would. Be resolute when God speaks. Act in faith immediately on what he says and never revise your decisions. If you hesitate when God tells you to do a thing, you endanger your standing in grace. Take the initiative. Take it yourself. Take the step with your will now. Make it impossible to go back. Burn your bridges behind you. I will write that letter. I will pay my debt. Make the thing inevitable. We have to get into the habit of hearkening to God about everything, to form the habit of finding out what God says. If, when a crisis comes, we instinctively turn to God, we know that the habit has been formed. We have to take the initiative where we are, not where we are not. Let us pray. Almighty Father God, we know what you have done and will do for us. Salvation, sanctification, restoration, reconciliation. But we also know that you expect us to be engaged in this sanctification road, as scripture says, to work out our salvation with fear and trembling. So Lord, in the holy fear of you and the trembling of the beauty of what you have done for us, help us to be resolute. Help us to carpe diem. Help us to seize the day, to make the decision, to take the step, to do the thing, not ask what is the thing to do, but do the thing. And may we do these things always to your great glory. In the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord and Savior, we pray. Amen. Once again, friends, I thank you for spending some time listening to Scripture being read and for considering what it is to be an active, involved, engaged disciple of Jesus Christ. Until we can get together again to do more of the same, I bid you, in the name of Jesus Christ, Shalom.